This is going to be the first in a series of a few videos on how I modeled and made this box in Fusion 360. The first step was modeling the sockets that were going to go in the box so that the box would fit them properly. In today's video, we're going to be looking at this little piece, which is the square drive socket adapter, and how I modeled it in Fusion. Check it out. The first thing I wanted to do is show everybody out there how I organize my Fusion models. And I think labeling is a very, very important thing that a lot of people sort of forget to do as they go. They just kind of get in a hurry. You will be much better off the better that you name your components and the pieces within your components. So you see, like, the DPT handle is that piece. The box body we already turned off. The entire socket set is a component, and then it has components within it with each of the names of the sockets. And you have to do these types of things to stay organized over the course of a project. So the box lid and the bracket we can turn off. And then we can actually come down to the square drive and say isolate, and that will isolate that one component. So we'll just take a quick look at it, and then we'll hop into a new session and we'll model this piece up. So just kind of taking a look at it, we've got a round barrel up here with some scallops taken out of it. Then we've got a little button here on top with a little fillet radius there. And down here we've got a little shoulder with a radius on it, and then a square drive that has chamfers on the edges, and then a bevel at the tip there. So let's fire up a new session, new design here, and we'll go ahead and save it, give it a name. We'll call it square drive. And the first thing I want to do is create a new component, and I'm going to call that the adapter. And so now we have our own component within a component sort of thing. So the first thing we're going to do is start here, and we're going to draw some circles to establish the scallops. And the outer radius of these is 0.38. And if it's a radius, it's asking us to type in a diameter. So I can just say times 2, and that will be the diameter that I need. Then the next circle I need for the scallops is kind of the inside of those scallops. And it is 0.343 times 2. Then I'm going to offset this guy because I know Fusion doesn't like coincident faces very much. So O for offset, and it picked the wrong one here. Here we go. O for offset, and it's going to be a negative value. We're just going to say negative point, maybe 0.01. There we go. We can do it after the fact. Then we're going to set up the scallops themselves. So if you hover over this center mark, it will start to guess what you want to snap to, and I wanted to snap to this quarter point of the circle. I'm going to type in 0.19 times 2, and that's going to actually give me a chord length between this snap point and that snap point of 0.19. It'll be a straight line. That's the only way I know to get a true chord length in CAD. Then we're going to go to the arc, three-point arc. Snap here, and then to this inner one, we want to make sure it's tangent. So that's what we're looking like. Then I can get rid of this circle. I can get rid of this circle and just kind of keep everything nice and clean. I want to create a circular pattern here. Center point being that piece right there, and then we're going to have, whoops, undo, select objects, that one, center point, that guy, and then we're going to have 6 objects in total. There we go. Okay. Now we can hit stop sketch. We're going to create the profile, so we're going to do another sketch. I want to do it on, undo, new sketch, that plane. And we're going to use a lot of the same values. So I'm going to draw a line from here. We're going to come out 0.333. And that should match up. Then we'll come up half an inch, so 0.5 inches. And then from there, we're going to take off at a 45 degree angle, so 135. And then we'll tab and just kind of drag that guy. The inside, we're going to come up straight there, 0.668 inches. Then we're going to come across. I don't have that dimension in my head. 0.38, all starting to match up with the other sketch that we did. And then we'll draw a line, we'll come down, and then we'll just trim these guys. So T for trim, and away we go. There's our basic profile. Then the last thing we need to do is come up here 0.07 inches that way, and then we're going to come across 0.126. And these were all measurements that I got from my calipers, just kind of sitting there measuring everything. That line doesn't look terribly straight. It is. The next thing we're going to sort of fudge a little bit, and it's this angle that comes down. It's just not a critical piece of the puzzle as far as this profile goes. So again, I'm going to use the trim tool. I'm going to trim up this guy. We're going to get rid of that piece of geometry, and that is our profile that we need. So if I come out here, I've got my profile. I want to do a create, revolve, pick this guy, and then the axis, we want to be that. So that is the main barrel of our shape, pretty simple to put together. So we'll hit the OK. Next, we need to extrude the scallops. We want to extrude them to this underside, and we can join them if it will let us. Sometimes it lets you, sometimes it doesn't. There it did. Again, on geometry that's close, sometimes it likes to freak out just a little bit. But you can see we left this little gap between our geometries, and if we didn't leave that gap, it wouldn't allow that extrusion to happen because everything is coincident. And for some reason or another, solid modelers do not like totally coincident geometry. So there we go. The next thing we can do is we can actually come back into here, and I want to call this my scallops. I want to call this sketch my profile. And I want to actually edit my profile sketch. So we're just going to add some cut geometry here. So I'm going to tab up again 135 degrees, tab down, and we're just going to drag random length. This is going to be used to cut our profile. I need to move these three things minus 0.01 inches. And it's going to not let me do that because it's coincident here. So if I pick this and say delete, we may be able to move that out. I don't know. Let's see how it's going to perform. Nope. So let's go one more time. Escape. Click U. Hey, buddy. I tell you what. Nope. This is the really, really frustrating thing about Fusion, is it thinks it's smarter than you like 90% of the time. It won't let you move things. It wants to over-constrain sketches, and it's really frustrating as a designer. If you're a guy just inputting CAD, you know, stuff, and you have all the dimensions and you're not trying to create something new, no big deal. But when you're trying to move things around and look at them, it's the most frustrating thing in the world because it doesn't let you be fluid with your thoughts. It takes just far too long to input things. That's me being complainy, but it's a fact. So here we go. We're gonna come out of here 45 degrees again. Nope. That's the wrong line. It's here, 45 degrees. Nope. 45, tab, there. Okay, so I need to draw a little bit of, come on, a little bit of a line here and here. And then the last thing I need to do is sketch an arc. Again, this is just for looks, so it's not hyper important that it's accurate in terms of dimension. We're gonna clean up, get rid of this line. We're gonna trim this one back just so everything looks nice when we get in here next time. Now, we should be able to, we're gonna revolve this piece first. Here we go, create, revolve. And we're gonna select the axis as that guy. And it's gonna cut our geometry at the bottom and put that nice little chamfer on the bottom there. And then we're gonna revolve this guy here. Same thing, we're gonna pick this axis. Everything should line up because we offset everything right. And that's looking really good for that half of the tool. The last piece on this top half, we're going to come in here, we're going to modify, we're going to create a fillet. We're going to pick this top edge, and I want to say we want something around 0.03. And I think that looks like the tool that I have in hand. So now we're going to turn our attention down here, and we're going to create the square drive adapter. So sketch, create sketch, we're going to pick that as our creation plane. Now, there's a few different ways you can do rectangles. If you do a center rectangle, you can actually come in here and it'll pull from the center, and we can type this in, and it is 0.372, and it's the same on both sides, so 0.372. Okay. And that is all the more sketch we need on that. So now we extrude this guy, and we want to extrude it 0.45 inches. Now we're going to come in and we're going to chamfer the edges of this. So we'll say chamfer, and we'll pick 1, 2, 3, rotate around, pick the fourth side. Oops. There we go. Pick the fourth side, and we are going to chamfer it 0.025. There we go. Then we need to do is cut the bevel on, or the chamfer, bevel, however you want to say that, on this. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a sketch, and we are going to do it on... trying to get to this plane right here. And this is going to be a cut. So I'm going to draw a couple construction lines here. So one is going to start from here. And I know that I am 0.32 divided by 2 is where I want to be. So I'm going to hit the enter button there. Then a line from here. We're going to say 45. Tab over, and okay, then down, then back up. Now that does not look right. According to my sketch, that is right. So we're gonna go with it. We're gonna just go with it. So let's stop the sketch. We'll click this guy, create, revolve. Again, we want to select the axis. We're going to have to zoom out just a little bit there. And that is our cut. Sorry, I got a little jumpy there, but I was looking at the distance. I didn't think it was right. So there it is. That is our square drive socket adapter and how to model it in Fusion. One little detail I forgot to show here. We're back into our profile for the main piece. We need to do the reveal that comes down the side. So I'm going to draw a line just here, and this is just a reference line. So we're going to change it
by hitting the X there, circle from somewhere in here, 0.01. Then we're going to dimension it from the center of that circle to here, and we're going to type 0.3. There we go. We'll stop the sketch. Now we can revolve, so create revolve. We're going to pick that circle, and then the axis is going to be, sometimes it's easier to see if you're slightly off there. There it is, 360 degrees. We've got it set to cut. And then you can change the objects to cut if you have multiple objects out there. That's just kind of a handy little thing to know. But we'll hit the OK button, and now you see that nice reveal. That is the end of our tool, which is awesome. So I want to say thanks to everybody for joining me. Hopefully I'll have a few more Fusion sessions like this. Just kind of share some general modeling techniques and from a design perspective, how I use the tool to create things that I wind up making on my CNC. So that's it. Take care. Thank you.
Feel free to click or tap on the images to check out some of my past builds. If you like my videos, click on the Greg's Garage logo and all my future videos will show up in your YouTube feed.